And that's what government did with marriage. God defined marriage. Government said, hey, we want it to be a different way than it is. We're going to redefine something that doesn't belong to us. And as you go back to founding fathers, Thomas Jefferson actually had, he introduced in 1779 laws in the state of Virginia that said marriage had to be defined by biblical definitions. James Wilson did the same, signed the Declaration and Constitution in Pennsylvania. For them, it was real simple. Government cannot get into that area. It doesn't belong to us. It belongs to God. We'll recognize what God's done, but it's not ours. We keep our hands off.
What you just spoke about is, I think, critical, which is it's not government that gives us marriage. It's marriage that makes government possible. And that is why perhaps one of the things we should touch on in this discussion is the fact that singleness, in other words, an obliteration of marriage, tends to give us tyranny in a society. And what's more, tyranny seems to stimulate a destruction and a pulverizing of marriage. A stable democratic government absolutely depends on marriage as the basic unit of society.